Montessori child is more rooted in the present because they use all their senses, you know, the touch, the sight, the smell, everything, they're very aware of the physical environment, you know, their spatial environment, how their hands are working accordingly, all of that. And we all know hands are the windows to the world. And from the early years, we've used tools to conquer the world, and we need our hands for that. So if you take away that, you're taking a very essential learning tool, you know, that we need. We evolved through this. We can't forgo using our hands. This is just very, very important because hands and brains are so interconnected, you know. When you touch something and you feel the texture of it, it starts a neural network to your brain saying, this is soft, this is rough, this is smooth, this is prickly. And when you do things, you know, fast or slow, your brain is learning things. But if you remove that, you give a phone into a child's hand, you know, there's just this flat screen touch, this sense, just this swiping. And that is what is removed from the child. You're actually taking away the child's right to learn, to grow as a person. So that's one major difference, using hands, because the child gets to feel things. You know, my daughter, she can feel a sphere. I didn't feel a sphere or a triangle prism or a cylinder physically. All the 12 years of my school years, you know, we were only shown the drawings, and I didn't really understand the concept. She's only 3 years old. I think they've done geometrical solids with her. So the cylinder shape, she sees the airtight container that holds her snacks at home. Amma, that's a cylinder, she says. She comes and tells me, Amma, see, look, this is a cylinder. She picks up a ball, Amma, this is a sphere, just like Earth. And I'm just so awed. Like, I'm just so grateful that, you know, I've seen, and the school, the Montessori pedigree, has seen fit to respect her intelligence, to give her the tools to, you know, navigate the world around her. So using the senses, there's also activities that makes the child to smell and identify spices. They actually, I think, they close their eyes and smell cloves, star anise, and find the difference, and also droplets to taste. And how many of us have really enjoyed the world around us like that? Because if this is school for you, smelling, tasting, touching, feeling, doing things, you'll definitely enjoy your life. You'll enjoy the world around you. I see my child go to a park. She removes her shoes. She wiggles her toes on the sand. I'm not kidding. And she says, Amma, this feels rough, but I like it. She says this in Tamil. And she'll touch the grass and she'll say, this feels wet, Amma. I feel like pulling it. And then she says, but plants are living things. I should not harm them. So this is just a three-year-old kid. And she's, all kids are able to do this. It's not that she's exceptionally bright. She is a normal, average kid. Every child has this potential. And Montessori, I feel, is the right way because it's child-centric. You know, child, spiritually speaking, we all believe that child's born perfect. That's very true. They have the inner spirit that guides them, pure spirit that guides them to, you know, this is curious, I want to learn more about this. This is this, that. It's not forced. And when once you ignite that curiosity, what could go wrong for them? That is what Montessori is about.